Clubhouse is in big trouble. Hi, my name is Brian, aka the BKH, and welcome to my channel. Today we're talking about Clubhouse. It is in trouble. So Clubhouse launched last year, April in 2020, and it has taken over 2020 and 2021. Now they're strong as ever. They have 10 million weekly users, with the bulk of those coming from January 2021 to now March 2021. Now, they've got competition on their heels. So Twitter Spaces has been testing, giving it to a few people, and loads of people have been using it, and they've been working out the bugs and all the features that they need to kind of get and launch with Twitter Spaces. They have been reported to be launching it at the end of March or very early April, and they've been giving it to loads of people. Now, already the features on Twitter Spaces are vastly different from Clubhouse. They have live audio transcription, so like the words come up as, you know, a second or two after you've said it. They've got reactions, so you can like clap and put thumbs up emojis on while people are talking. The user interface is way better. Personally for me on Clubhouse, I find it hard to see who's speaking because it's just a lighter brown ring around there, around the person who's speaking, and often you're kind of missing like who's speaking. Whereas with Twitter, it literally has a like an audio thing saying this person is talking, and it clearly says speakers and listeners. It's very, 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 very clear. And I heard they're coming with you can save the recordings after, so people can get the replays, and that's a big problem that I have with Clubhouse personally. Love live audio, love the concept, but I don't always have time to be listening to something right there and then. I'm usually doing something else when I want to do it, right? So what Twitter Spaces does not have is scheduling. You can't create a club and you can't name the room. So Clubhouse is winning on that front. Twitter Spaces are coming with a general space to kind of discover different spaces, which would be different from what Clubhouse looks like. Clubhouse obviously is just a feed, and I guess it's kind of got some kind of algorithm that feeds you the stuff, or maybe it doesn't. But right now it just looks like it's depending on who you know that might be in that room, or maybe there's an algorithm at play. I'm not really too privy to that information. Twitter, being its own platform previously, of course, has to create a separate space within Twitter itself to house like the directory of live audio that is going on and spaces that are happening, which should be very interesting to see and how that works and how you discover live spaces. I'm very excited for Twitter Spaces because I've been building my reputation on Twitter for a couple years now, as have other people, and it's automatically already accessible to the Twitter audience that you've been building with your reputation. And also it's going to be available on Android and iOS. Right now Clubhouse hasn't officially launched yet, so it's only on iOS and it's only invite only. They are working on a Android app and possibly a web app, but again they're a bit slow because they're a new company. So yes, they were valued at $1 billion after the recent round of investment they did, but that doesn't really mean much. It means they've got money now. And after that, they announced that they will be having new features like subscriptions, ticketing, and tips, which is great. They recently just launched their creators fund, which they want to give up to 20 creators 5K a month and some equipment and some guidance in creating their shows, so the creators can continue to flock to Clubhouse. Now, this is a really, really, really good thing. They are doing this right off the bat. Twitter isn't a place really for creators to kind of make money. Instagram is still struggling to do that. Facebook is doing what Facebook is doing. TikTok, they've got, you know, you can get a wallet on that, you can make money on live. YouTube is just gone. That's where all the creators kind of make money. So I love the fact that Clubhouse is coming with this early. They're prioritizing creators on the platform, because obviously if there's no creators, there are no listeners and there are no people on the platform coming to the platform. So they have to keep the creators on the platform. The best way to do that is throw them some money, but more importantly, support them and how they can help them, right? So those monetization features that are coming to Clubhouse are really, really helpful and really, really good, really exciting stuff. I don't know when they're actually going to launch the app, i.e. to Android, or when it's just not invite only. Also, they're not only in trouble because of Twitter Spaces. Facebook has been reported and seen to be working on their own version. No surprises there. And I'm sure Instagram is also working on their version, as they're one and the same company. I'm more excited to see it on Instagram than I am to see it on Facebook, but it is what it is. They're doing what they have to do to kill the competition. The messaging app Telegram, which kind of gained a lot of users due to the backlash from the WhatsApp privacy policy, also launched voice chats. Now, they launched voice chats a couple weeks ago, but now they've just taken it up a notch. They've literally just released Clubhouse. It's their version of Clubhouse. So now anyone can join an audio chat. And more importantly, they said you can have up to millions of people listening and talking in a room. There is no limit. While currently, Clubhouse has a limit of 5,000 people per room. When Elon Musk was on there, they had rooms that were getting the audio to another room, and YouTube lives and all these different lives, you know, because they couldn't get in a room. So anybody that was in the room was kind of just transferring the sound to other rooms and to other lives because the limit is 5,000 people. Now, obviously that's a problem. How do you moderate a room of 5,000 people, speakers, listeners, all these kind of things, moderators? It's a challenge. But Telegram have allowed the roof to come off in terms of the limit of people that can be in a room, which is another challenge. And they also said you can record these live chat rooms. Again, getting one up on Clubhouse that can't be recorded, which is a huge problem for me because I'm creating something that just disappears. And I understand the concept of the app. It's supposed to be like in-person conversations. You talk to someone, you walk away, the conversation is gone, isn't it? That was the conversation between you and that person or whoever was there. I get it, great concept, but this is the internet. This is social media. This is social audio media. We need to record it and be able to put it somewhere else. And obviously people are already doing that. People are already recording it, screen recording it, putting it through their computer, recording it with whatever device they can record it, putting it in their YouTube, putting it in their Instagram. I've seen it in all these different places. It's something that the people are going to want. That's what we're accustomed to doing. We have in real life conversations on the phone or in real life, and that's how it goes. But if it's going to be on the internet and it's going to be people dropping gems, business ideas, and all these different kind of things that's happening on live audio apps, we're going to need to record it. So Clubhouse, if they want to stay in the game, they're going to need to give us the recording. But do you think Clubhouse will survive when people get back to work, when outside is open again, when other apps are coming with the heavy competition, because that competition is gonna be fierce and they generally maybe have a few more resources and ecosystems for people to just use those features like live audio on an app that they've already built reputation on. Do you think Clubhouse will survive? Do you think Clubhouse is in hot water, danger? Are you still gonna be on Clubhouse? Let me know in the comments what you think about anything I just said about Clubhouse, Twitter Spaces, Facebook's version, and even Telegram. And I'll see you guys next time.